Paratumoral brain edema, a type of vasogenic edema. Paratumoral brain edema is a leading cause of morbidity and mortality in patients with brain tumors. Breakdown of the structural integrity of the blood-brain barrier and the subsequent increase in interstitial fluid mediates this type of brain edema, termed vasogenic brain edema. Paratumoral brain edema affects intracranial pressure, and this is one of the most serious complications in the management of intracranial neoplasms. Moreover, the severity and variety of paratumoral brain edema may limit operative exposure, and this frequently increases the difficulties of intraoperative procedures. Malignant brain tumors such as glioblastoma and metastatic brain tumors cause paratumoral brain edema because microvessels leak fluid from their lumens into the brain parenchyma. These malignant tumor vessels often lack tight junctions that are normally present in cerebral microvessels, and this can interfere with the function of the adjacent brain tissue. Tight junctions are specialized membrane domains that seal the intercellular spaces and act as a permeability barrier between the luminal and interstitial compartments. Tight junction proteins such as occludin, claudin, and adherens junction that bind across adjacent cell membranes to glue them together have recently been found. Occludin is the best characterized transmembrane protein, and it is a functional component of tight junctions, and it's widely expressed by essentially all epithelial and endothelial tissues. Occludin was the first identified transmembrane protein of tight junctions. Thus, the expression level of occludin directly affects the strength of the junctional seal in a manner that appears to depend on the genetic background of the analyzed cells. A possible explanation of this is that occludin is a regulatory component of the tight junction seal. Claudins were more recently discovered, and they are a family of tight junction proteins that weigh 22-24 kilodalton. Claudin 1 and 5 together with occludin are the most important constituents of the blood-brain barrier tight junctions. The expression of tight junction protein claudin 1 was lost in the majority of tumor microvessels, whereas claudin 5 and occludin were significantly downregulated only in hyperplastic vessels. Electron microscopy revealed opening of tight junctions of the microvessels in high-grade astrocytoma. The expression of tight junction protein occludin was reduced in these microvessels, and this reduction was inversely correlated with the degree of cerebral edema. Normal astrocytes secrete factors that induce barrier properties in endothelial cells, whereas high-grade astrocytomas secrete vascular endothelial growth factor, which stimulates angiogenesis, downregulates occludin, and increases endothelial cell permeability, which further increase the cerebral edema. Vascular endothelial growth factor plays an important role in both meningioma vascularity and paratumoral edema. Thus, vascular endothelial growth factor may be important in the pathogenesis of brain tumor edema by inducing a reduction in the expression of endothelial tight junction proteins, including occludin. Vasogenic edema and paratumoral brain edema is mediated primarily by vascular endothelial growth factor. Inhibition of vascular endothelial growth factor receptors with antibodies significantly decreases paratumoral brain edema. Although effective, vascular endothelial growth factor receptors inhibition is rarely used to manage isolated paratumoral brain edema. In the modern neuro-oncology era, dexamethasone is used commonly to manage paratumoral brain edema due to its potent glucocorticoid and low mineralocorticoid effects. Despite its potency, high doses of dexamethasone are required to achieve clinically relevant reduction in paratumoral brain edema and result in significant systemic side effects, particularly with prolonged use. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.